Hello and welcome to Pursuit of Perfect Systems video coverage for the Bristol HiFi Show 2019. We would like to thank our show coverage sponsors, Cord Electronics and Tellurium Q Cables, for helping us make this show coverage possible. We are starting the coverage with the outstanding demonstration from KEF, and there is lots more video coverage on its way. Hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and enjoy.
Good afternoon, everyone. How are we doing? Yes, welcome to the hottest room in the show. More than one reason. Strong beard, by the way.
Loving it.
That's right, it's an unwritten code. Welcome to the KEF room. You all familiar with the brand KEF? You all own it?
Yeah.
Good. For those that don't, hopefully at the end of the presentation you'll rush out and buy something. Feel free, there's some seats available should you want to take a seat. It's more comfortable, it's going to be about 20 minutes. Anyway. My name's Ron, I'm from KEF, this is my colleague Nick, and we're a loudspeaker manufacturer based down in Maidstone in Kent. In fact, that means Kent Engineering Foundry. It's the site we were founded on back in 1961, and I'm happy to say we're still there now, so if you ever pass in Maidstone you want to pop in for a brew and have a look around, we'll happily have you down. Since last year's show, obviously where we focused majorly on the LS50 wireless, we've been pretty busy. And towards the end of last year, we launched two brand new products. The first product we're going to talk about is the new little diminutive LSX, and that's an addition to an existing strong family of LS products. The LS story typically harks back to the mid-60s when Raymond Cook, our founder, who was a former BBC engineer, struck up a really strong relationship with the technical department of the BBC, who wanted to commission a loudspeaker for outside broadcast vehicles and near-field monitoring of recordings, which were then shipped off around the world. That product was called an LS358, and as you can see in the cabinet to the left there, we've got an example of that. It was built under license from the BBC for other manufacturers like Harvard, Spendor, Audio Master, and Rogers, companies like that. But each LS358 was sold had to feature the KEF drive units and crossovers. That was the criteria. Fast forward to 2011, when we celebrated our 50th anniversary, we introduced that product called the LS50. The LS50 was designed very much with the same spirit of the original LS358. It's an engineer's loudspeaker. It's using technology that was available to us for the modern day. And then we moved forward a few more years to 2017, and that's where we decided to take that little LS50 passive loudspeaker and effectively build it into a complete system. So we've got our own engine into that product, our own amplification, our own DAC, our own streaming connectivity, as well as a lot of other really cool things. That's a £2,000 Hi-Fi system. It sounds extremely big and powerful and immense for that type of size product, and obviously with the connectivity you get on it, it's very, very good value for money. But it's still a relatively large loudspeaker, and maybe the price point maybe is a little bit too keen, perhaps. So we did a lot of consumer research, and we decided to introduce a product not only was almost half the size, but also half the price, but still keeping that everything that's cool about the LS50 in the main. So that allowed us to introduce this little product here. This is called the LSX, and as you can see, KEF's gone sexy. We've got five really, really lovely finishes. The blue, the red, the white, the green, and obviously the black there. Because it's a small box, it gives us a little bit more freedom as to how we package it. And this is covered in a material sourced in Denmark by a company called Kvadrat. I hope I said that right. And as you can see, the colour of the cloth also colour matches the drive units and the front baffle, and it's a bit of fun. The white comes in a gloss white finish for obvious reasons. If that was in white cloth, it would be grubby rather quickly and you'd be really disappointed. So, that's the LSX. It's small, yes it is, but there's nothing that we've compromised on. We've crammed a hell of a lot into this little product. We still use principally the same approach as we do with the LS50 wireless. We still have a master and slave configuration. The master carries all of the pre-amplification section on board, so it's got the Wi-Fi over network, it's got Bluetooth connectivity, it's got connectivity for Spotify, Rune and Tidal, so you can also use this as a Rune endpoint. But it also has other additional inputs as well, even though it is a relatively small enclosure. It's got an optical digital input, so if you want to enhance your television sound, that's the way to do it. Also, if you have a record deck with a built-in phono stage, the analog input is the way to do it, or any other analog device. It also has a dedicated subwoofer output, so should you want to enhance the bass frequencies, whether it's for a 2.1 system or just get bigger bass in the room, then you can achieve that using the subwoofer output. Bear in mind, this is a ridiculously small loudspeaker, and if you take a cross-section of this, the electronics take up almost a third of the box. The drive unit sits almost into half of the box, so that leaves very little air left to achieve good, low, strong bass. And that's basically the law of physics. The bigger the enclosure, the bigger the drive of the unit, the more extension you can achieve. But, you know, we've been a little bit tricky with this. We're very smart at what we do. One of the benefits over this product compared to its bigger brother, the LS50, is that you can use these completely wirelessly between the two products. You don't have to have them tethered together. We do it for the LS50 wireless. The reason we do it for that is because we're achieving full 192 24-bit output resolution and capability. And to do that, you have to have a link between the two to obviously maintain that strong digital link without any latency issues. Obviously, with this type of product, we think the customer for this type of product maybe isn't so worried about that as an option. So, using it completely wirelessly will give you standard CD quality, 48K, 16-bit. And that, to most consumers, certainly to me, is good enough. Okay. So we've got it set up here completely wirelessly. There is a wire coming out the back. That's the electricity that we need to obviously drive the amplifiers. There's 100 watt amplifiers in each speaker. There's also DAC or DACs on board each speaker as well. So exactly the same principle as we've got the LS50 wireless. I'm going to do something pretty silly, really. I'm going to send music from my telephone that I've downloaded wirelessly to the LSX, but by Bluetooth. I know I'm crazy, I'm a rebel. The little blue circle here depicts which input it's on, and you can change the input via the app that we encourage you to download when you buy these latest plans, set them up tonight. If it's a green ring, it's Spotify Connect. If it's the white ring, it's Wi-Fi. And if it's the purpley pink ring, it's the auxiliary input. So visually you can see what input it's on. It also comes with a really smart little remote control, but you can also control it via your handheld device. So we thought about everything, really. So let's play some music. This is a track called Liberty by a young lady called Annette Askvik, A-S-K-V-I-K. Should you want to look her up, go and listen.
Our bodies are hurting like hell. They promise to never leave us alone. Our hearts are breaking like bones. Picking stars like apples from the sky, threatening to throw them in the sea, so we won't have anything to gaze upon. What happened to liberty and the bridges we almost got done? What happened to them? What's going to take us home?
Good at that way. worth taking, right? Sounds pretty big, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Got that huge, beautiful image filling this room. This is a 48 square meter room. And we're asking this little product to do a hell of a lot. And when I said earlier you can achieve more bass by adding a subwoofer, I don't really think you need it in a real listening room. You've got good bass depth there. If you do tether them together, you can double the output resolution, so 96 by 24 bit. So, you know, for those purists that want a little bit better sound quality, you can achieve that. We haven't neglected that as a feature. As I say, we're asking this to do a hell of a lot. The reason we can get that amount of scale and output from this little thing is quite simply via DSP. And it's the DSP platform that we also use in the LS50 wireless. And by telling the speaker the environment that it's actually positioned in, it can adjust its EQ intelligently to suit the environment it's playing. So I've told it, we're sitting on a desk. We're this close to the edge of the desk. We're that far away from the solid wall. It's a big room. It's moderately damped. It's not overly damped. It's not too bright or not too anechoic. And it's going, okay, I'll take that information. I'll adjust myself to suit it. And that's pretty crudely done. That's done on the app as you set them up initially. Once you've done that, and once you sit there and you're starting to enjoy them and you run them in a bit and you'll get familiar with it, once you're playing your favorite tracks, you can then go in on the fly and change the trim. You can trim the HF, you can trim the bass, again, to suit your personal listening tastes. Or you can also set a profile. So if you're using this as a TV system and you want to enhance the vocals more for when you're listening to the news or for Coronation Street or whatever, you can set that profile and it will adjust itself to suit that listening environment. Equally, when you're listening to music and you want more bass, you want a hell of a lot more dynamics, again, you can set that profile and go, right, I'm listening to music now, hit that profile, all the EQ changes to suit that for you. And that's something that we've built into this. So when you weigh it all up, this is pretty good value for money. When you consider you've got a Wi-Fi over network streamer, Bluetooth connectivity, Spotify Connect, Tidal and room compatibility, plus all the inputs for adding other devices, and the sound quality, you'd be hard pushed to find a system around £1,000 separately to do that. Same principles we've got with the LS50 wireless. We'll play another track, because obviously that was a nice little introduction, sort of get wet your appetite, you know, give you an idea of scale and how effortless these things are. We'll try something a little bit different. This is by a young lady called Holly Cook. Now, no one so far knows who Holly Cook is.
Perfect.
The only guy here all day. You do, you win something, I don't know what you win. You can take these if you want, they're dummies. I'm impressed. I'm impressed you know that. But that's perfect, so you'll be familiar with Holly Cook, and hopefully by the end of this, she'll have some more fans as well. So this is a track called 99, and it's from an album called Twice, and this is Holly Cook. Have a listen to what you think. And this is a little bit different, just to give you an idea of what these can do in terms of sheer output. But again, Bluetooth. Thank you. holding its own. That's purely down to really good engineering, really clever DSP, and the fact that all the amplifiers and the drive units are that close together, so we haven't got all these long cables to worry about, so that doesn't give you any latency issues. So that's the LSX. It's a cute little thing. The only difficult decision you really need to make today is what colour you go for. Because naturally you're going to rather buy it. So, yeah, of course. So this is a great little solution for someone that's looking for a way in with a convenient little system without the hassle of pair matching different components and worrying about the cabling and then speakers on the end of it. It can be quite a long, laborious process. This is a convenient way of getting into a cool brand like KEF. But we understand that there are purists out there, there are hi-fi enthusiasts, and there are people that want to build their own system. And that's absolutely fine, because we also cater for that too. And towards the end of last year, we introduced a brand new range to our family of products called the R-Series. And some of you will be familiar with the outgoing R-Series. It was around almost 8 years. And that's a hell of a long time for a product range to be in the marketplace. Typically, we kind of benchmark around 4, maybe 5, sometimes 6 at a push, depending on where it sits in its level. Never 8 years. But during that 8 year period, we also developed another range called the Reference. And we bought them here a couple of years ago. Hopefully, some of you managed to see it. And during that process of developing the Reference series, we learned better techniques and better ways of doing things within the development process and within the engineering capacity that we had. You know, our processes moved on, our techniques moved on, how we handle air within the boxes moved on, how we get good excursion out of base drivers moved on, crossover design, airflow through ports, everything like this, complete computational fluid dynamics. If you remember that next year, I'll give you a prize. It's all these things that we learned within Reference Series that then, when we introduced that to the market, it left this massive gulf between our series and Reference Series, because technically before it was a lot closer. So, and we knew that our series was coming up to the end of its lifespan, so we thought, well, let's scrap what we did with our series. Not that it's a bad product, but it is old technology, and we've learned so much moving forward. So we introduced this range solely from the ground up. It's completely new. There's nothing about the old range that features in this range. The only thing that does still exist is the name. That's it, purely that. So, the base drivers are brand new. The cabinets are brand new. The way we set the labyrinth, the bracing internally is brand new. The way that bracing is then touching other parts of bracing is brand new. The way we load the ports, they're even offset and they're flexible, so it overcomes that lower mid-range chuffing noise that we used to get from solid ports. The crossovers, brand new, and they're minimal first order because the drive units are so good, we don't need huge amounts of filtering within our crossovers. So that keeps the signal path nice and clean and very clear. But the biggest change we've probably made to this range is probably this device here. Now, as you look around the room, with the exception of the LS35A, you'll notice that everything has a UniQ driver array. That's our proprietary technology. It's technology that we own, we invented it, no one else can use it. And the reason for that is it overcomes two really quite big issues when it comes to loudspeaker design. And that's the time alignment and the acoustic alignment between the tweeter and the mid-range, okay? By coincidentally mounting the tweeter at the acoustic center of the mid-range, we've overcome those two issues. So we've now got official time alignment and acoustic alignment between these two devices. And it's all coincidentally mounted in this very nice, neat little package. So this, because of the improvements that we made to this particular UniQ, has classified it as a 12th generation UniQ. What that means is, when I first joined the company back in 89, we had generation 1. 30 years later, we're now on generation 12. We're constantly evolving this technology. We're constantly moving it forward and improving it. So now things like how we handle the air behind the dome on the tweeter has been massively improved and changed. The way we deal with heat dissipation, the way it's vented behind it, all these things add to all these big improvements that you'll hear sonically. So this is a brand new UniQ array, and we're very, very proud of it. It sits quite neatly between the improved bass drivers and inside the improved cabinet. Now, we own the whole process of this product. We designed, developed it, engineered it all in the UK. It's all hand-built by us. We make our own cabinets, we finish our own cabinets, we make our own tooling. So all of these components are all made by us. We make our own drive units, we make our own chassis, we make our own shadow flares, we make everything about this product. So we've got full 100% control on the whole thing. We don't rely on other manufacturers supplying us drive units, so we can then put them in our fruity boxes and hope it makes a nice noise. It's different. It's much, much more important to us than that. What you'll notice as you look along the back of the room is the rest of the family, and this unit here is the common part between all of the products in the family. So we start with the R3, that's the stand mounter we've got there, we've got one over here as well. That's currently our wont HiFi product of the year, and that comes in at £1,300. Next to that, we've got the compact floor stander, that's the R5, that comes in at £2,000. Aside from that, in between the big one, is the mid price or the mid sized floor stander, that's called the R7, and that comes in at £2,600. And then topping out the range is the R11, which we've got featured here in walnut as well as here in black, and these come in at £4,000 per pair. So not only cosmetically, aesthetically, but acoustically, they're now closer to what we've got going on the reference series. And we make no apology for the fact that this R11 looks like a reference 5. Okay, it works. This geometry works, this layout of drive units works, and by going for smaller drive units but multiples, allows us to keep the box really narrow instead of having a wider baffle. So a narrower baffle helps everything acoustically. So again, all of that has been paid close attention to. This pair of speakers is £4,000, and in this arrangement here, we've got a little, quite a modest hi-fi system that we're going to demonstrate to you. We've got a Heagle H190. This is at £3,300. It's not a massively powerful amplifier. We're not using a stack of power amps. These speakers are that good, they don't need that level of power, so they're very efficient. We're running all of our music, which is stored here on this in-use Zen Mark 3. It's this one here, and that's 3,000. And they're cabled together using cord Epic. So the whole system comes in at £10,000. And it's deliberate that we bought a £1,000 Wi-Fi system, and we're going to compare it to a £10,000 Wi-Fi system. Obviously there are massive differences, but it gives you an idea what we're up to, from the smallest thing we do, obviously up to the new biggest thing that we do. So have a listen to it. What are we listening to?
Buddy Holly?
Why not? Buddy Holly.
Just you know why.
Acoustically transparent. Now, when you look at these, are accessories. Obviously, if you've got animals and kids and things like that, you know, the temptation to poke domes and things like that is pretty strong. I've got a little granddaughter. She doesn't touch them anymore. She's outgrown that, but you know, thankfully,
she's her hands as well.
Thankfully, with the crown horn, it's more of a deterrent than especially when you come up to electricity, so it gives them a buzz when they touch it. But things like, you know, owning the whole process really gives us the freedom to do pretty much whatever we want to do with it. And we look at different things, and even people maybe not use grills, or will not use grills, but if you do, use sexy grills like this. This is very different to what you see elsewhere by other brands. This is like an Alcantara feel to it. It's a multi-layer process. It's very thin. It's hiding little metal plates in here, which fit magnetically to the front of the speaker. It looks very clean. It's totally acoustically transparent, so it does have no detrimental effect on the mid-range and high frequency. We've measured it. I promise you it doesn't. And it keeps the front of the driver or the front of the speaker extremely clean. In addition to that, when you look at the speakers that are around the room, we also pay very close attention to the way the drivers complement the cabinet. It's very easy for most manufacturers to build one bass drive unit that's common across most different ranges and then put that drive unit in regardless of the colour of the box. We think that's like a pimple on the chin. We've overcome that a little bit by designing or pigmenting the finish to suit the drive unit or to suit the cabinet. So in the white, in the case of the white, we've gone for a light stardust silver, which looks a little more complementary, and that's with a darker grey grill. Obviously we don't use white grills, the reason for that, they get grubby and look horrible. For the brown or the walnut finish that we've got at the back of the room there, we've gone for more of a bronze finish to the drive units, the UNIQs, the shadow flares and the bass units, and that complements that finish too. And equally with the black, we've gone full black at the front. So have a little feel of that, pass that around, you're welcome to. Oh, grills are sexy. It's all good.
Can you buy just the grills?
Sorry?
Can you buy just the grills?
You need to buy the speakers to put them on.
Well, no, I've got 700s.
Oh, yeah?
You buy the grills and you get the speakers free.
Yeah, the grills are £4,000.
I bought them last year.
Bless you. They're still good speakers, don't worry about it. So,
that's
the R11. I think we'll finish on something just to wake everyone up a little bit. I know I've been hopping on a bit, but the last track we're going to play is...
Effective Mushroom. That's our brief introduction to our LSX and our new R series. Should you want any more information, come and ask. We've got some brochures here for you, we can give to you. You have any questions regarding KEF products, these products, anything KEF, doesn't have to be a DAC KEF. You just want to come up and have a chat or a cuddle, we can do that too. I really appreciate your time. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon. I think there's a couple of hours left of the show. Grab some bargains while you can. Thanks very much.
Cheers.
Great day, everyone. Thank you.
Thanks, Terry.